TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Thursday, the 2nd of January. Firefighter killed during rescue operations in Delhi factory fire. Pakistan rushes out draft bill on Army Chief's extension. And Nepal launches Visit Nepal Year 2020 campaign to promote tourism. And now for all the details, a firefighter succumbed to his injuries in a building collapse triggered by a blast and fire in New Delhi on Thursday. At least 10 others were injured in the incident that occurred after a fire broke out at a battery factory in the Indian capital.
A fire services personnel was killed and at least 10 people were injured in a building collapse triggered by a blast and fire in Indian capital New Delhi on Thursday. The incident occurred around 4:30 in the morning after fire broke out at a battery factory in New Delhi's Piragadi area. The fire then led to a blast which caused portion of the building to collapse, thus trapping several people, including firefighters who had entered the building to carry out rescue operations.
Four aadmi jo the building collapse mein dab gaye the. उनको शुरू में एक दो आदमी को जल्दी निकाल लिया गया था दो आदमी बहुत देर बाद निकल पाया उनमें से एक जो अभी 5 बजे के 2:30 बजे 3 बजे के करीब निकला है उसको ब्रॉड डेड डिक्लेअर किया हॉस्पिटल
Meanwhile in another incident a fire broke out at a cycle factory in northern Ludhiana city around 10 fire tenders were present at the spot till the last reports came in and no casualties were reported
India has reached out to countries across the world on the issues of the Citizenship Amendment Law and the proposed National Register of Citizens, Foreign Ministry spokesperson Ravish Kumar said on Thursday. The new citizenship law has triggered widespread protest across India since December 11th when it was passed.
India has reached out to countries across the world on the issues of the Citizenship Amendment Act and the proposed National Register of Citizens, Foreign Ministry spokesperson Ravish Kumar said on Thursday. Addressing media, Kumar said that it was emphasized that the new citizenship law just expedites acquiring of citizenship to persecuted minorities and it does not change basic structure of the constitution. Kumar also informed that India has explained its position to Bangladesh government and said it is an internal matter. Last month, Bangladesh expressed concern that any uncertainty in India was likely to affect its neighboring countries.
We did reach out to countries across all geographical regions. We did write to our missions and posts. We did tell them that to share our perspectives on CA and NRC to the host government.
The Citizenship Amendment Act paves way to Indian citizenship to non-Muslims who entered India before 2015 after facing religious persecution in Muslim-majority Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan. The law has triggered widespread protests across northeastern Assam province and rest of India since December 11 when it was passed.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's federal cabinet has approved an amendment to the Army Act in light of the Supreme Court's directions last month in a case pertaining to an extension in the tenure of Army Chief General Kamar Javed Bajwa. The top court had given the government 6 months to set the tenure and other service terms.
Pakistan's federal cabinet has approved proposed amendments to the Constitution and the Army Act. In order to give a 3-year extension to Chief of the Army Staff General Kamar Javed Bajwa. The Cabinet, at an urgent meeting chaired by Prime Minister Imran Khan on Wednesday, said, according to an amendment, the maximum age limit for an Army Chief will be 64 years and this will be applied in case of extension in Bajwa's term. But the regular age limit of Chief of the Army Staff will be 60 years. This comes over a month after Pakistan's Supreme Court had given the government 6 months to set the tenure and other service terms of the Chief of the Army Staff through an Act of Parliament. The apex court in November 2019 had suspended the government's notification of Bajwa's extension until November 2022, citing procedural loopholes, but granted a temporary 6-month extension to his tenure, which was due to end on the night of November 28.
Moving on, activists in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have expressed concerns over the condition of Neelam River due to the construction of a hydropower project. They said a similar proposed project on the Jhelum River has compounded worries of the locals in the illegally occupied region.
Members of Safe River Committee on Wednesday gathered near the confluence of Neelam and Jhelum Rivers in Pakistan-administered Kashmir and expressed concern over environmental damage caused due to diversion of the Neelam River. The activist highlighted that the condition of the Neelam River has deteriorated due to a tunnel constructed for Neelam-Jhelum hydropower project. They also expressed concerns over the proposed Kolaha project on Jhelum River, which is likely to aggravate the situation.
دریائے جہلم گزر رہا ہے بہ رہا ہے اور دریائے جہلم کی جو کنڈیشن ہے ظاہری کنڈیشن آپ دیکھ رہے ہیں ابھی تک یہ دریا کسی ٹنل کی نظر نہیں ہوا جو کہ فل تگیانی سے بہ رہا ہے اور اس سائڈ بیک سائڈ پہ دیکھیں جبکہ دریائے نیلم ہے یہ دو ہزار سولہ میں ڈیم کی نظر ہو گیا ہے آج اس کی کنڈیشن ایسی ہے آج اس کی کنڈیشن دیکھ رہے ہیں آپ یہ دریا بالکل
Activists have long raised concerns over rampant destruction of natural resources and ecology in the illegally occupied region through the so-called development projects by Pakistan. They blame that any voice of dissent that seeks to resist the exploitative agenda of Pakistan is muzzled with force.
In news from Afghanistan, the U.S. envoy to Afghanistan, John Bass, has said that it is important for Taliban to recognize the opportunities when they exist, as political situation allowing peace talks won't necessarily last forever.
U.S. Ambassador to Afghanistan, John Bass, has said that it is important for Taliban to recognize the opportunities when they exist, as political situation allowing peace talks won't necessarily last forever. John Bass, who is ending a 2-year term as a U.S. envoy in Kabul, in an interview with a local media outlet on Wednesday said the Taliban has taken much time to think about whether it is going to respond to the overwhelming desire of the Afghans or not. The remarks by the ambassador came 2 days after the group denied agreeing to any ceasefire in Afghanistan after media reports claimed of a potential deal that would see a reduction in violence and a temporary ceasefire. In a statement released on Twitter, the Taliban said it has no intention of declaring a ceasefire. Meanwhile, Afghan forces backed by international troops are bracing for another bloody winter amid renewed U.S.-Taliban talks after U.S. President Donald Trump abruptly called them off earlier this year. Peace talks between the Taliban and U.S. resumed last month following Trump's first ever visit to Afghanistan over Thanksgiving, but the process again witnessed a brief pause after the group attacked a key U.S. military base.
And news from Nepal, Nepal's President Vidya Devi Bhandari on Wednesday formally inaugurated the Visit Nepalia 2020 campaign to boost tourism in the Himalayan nation. The government of Nepal has claimed that the latest ploy is essential to make tourism one of the supporting pedestals of the economy.
While the world welcomed 2020 with gaiety, Himalayan nation Nepal chose to welcome it in its own way by launching the Visit Nepal 2020 campaign. The campaign kick-started in all 7 provinces of the country with an aim of creating a buzz about the country's tourism sector across the globe and bringing 2 million tourists by the end of the decade. Nepal's President Vidya Devi Bhandari tossed up Unity Lamp at the Saratha Stadium, formally inaugurating the campaign, which will run on for a year.
यो अभियान सबैको सहयोग र सहभागितामा महाअभियानकै रूपमा
अगाडि बढ्ने छ भन्ने मैले विश्वास लिएको छु नेपाल संसारकै उत्कृष्ट पर्यटकीय गन्तव्य हो हामी हाम्रा अमूल्य स्रोत र सम्भाव्यताहरूलाई मनन गर्न मात्र होइन उजागर गर्नका लागि लागिपरेका छौँ
Mythical creature Yeti has been selected as mascot of the year-long campaign, as well as stickers targeting ambitious drive also was launched over messaging and calling app Viber. The government of Nepal has claimed that the latest ploy is essential to make tourism one of the supporting pedestals of the economy. Tourism sector has been contributing around 3% of the total of Nepal's gross domestic product. With the 15-5-year plan marching towards completion, the government has aimed to increase the figure to 10%.
Local administration in India's southern Kochi city created a huge artistic installment recently titled Trap, depicting the menace of pollution caused by single-use plastic.
An art installation titled The Trap with discarded plastic bottles in Fort Kochi of southern Kerala province put the spotlight on plastic pollution earlier this week. Local administration in Kochi city created the 25-foot installation depicting the menace of pollution caused by single-use plastic. The installation in the shape of a huge plastic bottle was created by smaller bottles and inside them were human puppets appearing to try to stop walls closing in, conveying how plastic pollution affects humans in a race against time. From children to grown-ups, visitors were actively checking out the installation.
I create a man in the bottle and bottle man is itself preventing the plastic, preventing the pollution and his hands is like this and inside a man is already trapped and he stands like this and inside there is 18 mirrors that we can see the reflections of plastic so many layers and we are trapping inside.
The bottles required for making the installations were collected from littered public places. The mirrors inside installation represent the deep-rooted problem and magnitude of plastic pollution with countless reflections. The project was sponsored by Cochin Shipyard and cost of the project is estimated as $2,105.
Sikhs across India on Thursday celebrated the 353rd birth anniversary of the 10th spiritual leader, Guru Gobind Singh, by offering prayers and taking out colourful processions.
Sikhs across India on Thursday celebrated the 353rd birth anniversary of their 10th spiritual leader, Guru Gobind Singh. A huge crowd of devotees gathered to offer prayers at the birthplace of Guru Gobind Singh in Patna city of India's eastern Bihar province, where he was born in the year 1666. Among the major contributions of Guru Gobind Singh include mobilizing of Sikhs into a martial community in 1699 for protection of their religious beliefs during Mughal rule. He also ended the concept of religious leader in bodily form by instituting the holy scripture Guru Granth Sahib as the eternal spiritual guide.
ਇਸ ਸਾਲ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਬੜੀ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਮੇਂ ਜੋ ਸ਼ਰਧਾਲੂ ਵਿਦੇਸ਼ੋਂ ਸੇ ਆਏ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਉਸਸੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਜੋ ਲੋਕਲ ਸੰਗਤ ਹੈ ਯਹਾਂ ਕੀ ਜੋ ਬਿਹਾਰ ਕੇ ਨਿਵਾਸੀ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਦੂਸਰੇ ਧਰਮ ਕੇ ਲੋਕ ਹੈ ਉਨਕੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਹੈ ਉਨਮੇਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਉਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਵੋ ਇਸ ਵਕਤ ਆਪ ਦੇਖ ਸਕਤੇ ਹੈ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਉਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਸੇ ਵੋ ਲੋਕ ਯਹਾਂ ਦਰਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਨੇ ਆਏ ਹੈ
Meanwhile, to mark the occasion, a vibrant procession was organized on Wednesday from the famous Golden Temple, which toured the whole city of Amritsar and concluded at the same spot. Throughout the procession, devotees sang devotional hymns, school children played musical instruments, while some also performed Gatka, the Sikh form of martial art. Sikhs form about 2% of nearly 1.3 billion population of India. And are largely concentrated in the northern Indian province of Punjab and national capital New Delhi.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.